Now, without further ado, ang unahin po natin is yung legal definition of firearms or arms. Pareho lang po yan, ha? Firearms or arms. Basahin po natin. Ang firearms or arms refers to any handled or portable weapon, whether a small arm or light weapon that expels or is designed to expel a bullet, shot, slug, missile, or any projectile which is discharged by means of expansive force of gases from burning gunpowder or other form of combustion or any similar instrument or implement. For purposes of this act, the barrel, frame, or receiver is considered to be a firearm. Number one po na dapat nating i-take note. Diba sa previous episode, we talk about projectile. Projectile could be a metallic or non-metallic material that is propelled by means of a combustion. So una po nating tandaan in the definition of firearms, ang firearms po or ang arms refers to a weapon na mag-discharge ng projectile. Ang projectile na ito, pwedeng tawagin natin na shot, pwedeng tawagin natin na bullet, pwedeng tawagin natin na missile, pwedeng tawagin natin na slug. Later on, we can learn kung ano po ang differences sa mga terms na ito. Kung ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng slug, ano bang ibig sabihin ng shots, ano bang ibig sabihin ng bullet. Pero again, una pong tandaan, ang firearms or arms, weapon po yan that can discharge a projectile. Number two, ang projectile na na-discharge should be by means of an expansive force of gases coming from a burning gunpowder or other form of combustion. I repeat, dapat po yung na-discharge, ha, yung na-discharge na projectile should be by means of an expansive force of gases coming from a burning gunpowder. Ang tanong, saan ba nanggaling yung burning gunpowder? Diba, sa episode 1, we talk about interior ballistics. Pag na-hit yung primer by the firing pin, it will create an ignition. Yung ignition, pupunta po siya, it will conflagrate on the gunpowder. The gunpowder po, mag-burn po yan sa loob ng ammunition. And it will create pressure. Okay, it will create pressure inside the cartridge or inside the ammunition. Tapos, it will propel sa bullet. So again, sa number 2 po, dapat tandaan ang pag-discharge ng projectile dapat by means of combustion po yan. Okay? Pangatlo, based on the definition of firearms, ang barrel po, yung frame or receiver, considered na po siya na firearm. Huwag kalimutan, ha, yung receiver, yung frame, or yung barrel, firearm na po yan. Okay? Now, bago po ang batas natin, this definition is in accordance to Republic Act 10591. 10591 is known as the Comprehensive Firearms and Ammunition Regulation Act. Yan na po ang bagong batas natin. Ang tanong ngayon, okay? Marami po ang criminology students who are still confused right now. Ang tanong, can you consider yung airsoft, diba? Airsoft or airgun to be a firearm? Qualified po ba ang airsoft or airgun sa definition natin sa firearm or arms under Republic Act 10591? Ang sagot po dyan, hindi. Okay? Hindi po. Airsoft and airguns are excluded in the definition of firearms or arms. Ano po ba ang rason? Ha? Paglalabas to sa board examination, ano ang rason? Kasi ang sabi dito sa legal definition of firearms, ang projectile dapat is propelled or discharged by means of an expansive force of gases coming from a burning gunpowder or coming from a combustion. Yung airsoft po or airgun na ginagamit natin, wala po yung combustion. The projectile po is propelled coming from the airsoft or the airgun because of the air, a pressurized air, but not coming from a combustion. So again, sasabihin ko na ngayon, yung airsoft airgun natin, hindi po yan included. It cannot be considered as a firearm under Republic Act 10591. pangalawang tanong. Sir, ang airsoft tsaka yung airgun, kasi they are not included in the definition of firearms under Republic Act 10591. Kailanganin ba, sir, ang registration sa airsoft at saka sa airgun? Ang sagot po dyan, take note ka din sa, baka lalabas to. Ang sagot dyan, yes. Kailanganin po ang registration natin sa airsoft at sa airgun. Kailanganin yan. We will talk about that later on. I-explain ko po yan comprehensively para maintindihan po natin. Now, sir, may mga pellet guns po na nabibili namin. Yung mga pellet guns, di ba? Sa mga stores, yung ginagamit natin pampatay ng ano, pampatay ng botike, or we usually use this airsoft or airguns for fun, di ba? For fun lang po. Di ba? Yung projectile na is yung plastic na pellets, di ba? Ginagamit natin 'yan. Pag may mga fiesta, di ba, makikita natin 'to. Sir, ang tanong ngayon, yung mga toys na mga pellet guns, kasali ba 'yan? Does it need registration? Ang sagot ko po dyan, cadets, ganito. We have to define first kung ano yung airsoft o kung ano yung airgun. So kung basahin po natin sa PNP Circular Number 11, para maging comprehensive tayo ha, para maintindihan. Ganito po ang definition nila. Yung airsoft rifle or pistol is defined herein, used includes battery operated ha. Pangalawa, spring and gas type powered rifles and pistols. Yung pellet guns po natin, yung may projectile na pellets, yung plastic po, is actually using a spring in order to propel the projectile. So ang tanong ngayon, balik po tayo. Kasali ba 'yan sa airsoft o sa definition ng airgun? Ang sagot po, yes. Okay? Now, yung airsoft rifle pistol differs from replica as the latter does not fire plastic or rubber pellet. Ano ba yung replica? It's just a replica. It's just a kind of somewhat like a gun or somewhat like a firearm. Forma po siya ng firearm, pero it does not propel something. Okay? So, sa definition po nito, ang airsoft rifle or airsoft pistol, again po, yung nag-propel ng projectile, it either could be battery-operated, spring, or gas type. Okay? So, dapat po alam natin to ha. Now, punta tayo sa registration, cadets. Punta tayo sa registration. I really doubt that this topic was discussed during your college days. I really doubt. So, importante po that you have to dwell in this kind of topic, kasi who knows, this will come out in the board examination. At least, at the same time, may knowledge na tayo in terms of airsoft or airgun. Now, punta tayo sa registration. Ang tanong ko kanina, in the first slide, kailanganin pa ba ang registration ng airsoft tsaka yung airgun? Sabi ko kanina ha, airsoft and airgun are not firearms. Pangalawang tanong, are airsoft or airguns need to be registered? The answer po is yes. Kailanganin po. Now, registration. One-time registration in case of transfer of ownership to a qualified citizen, the required procedure in the transfer of regular airguns shall apply. Ano ba ibig sabihin nito? Meaning, kailanganin po siyang i-register. Saan po ba i-register natin? Sa Firearms and Explosive Office ng Philippine National Police? Ha? Sa Firearms and Explosive Office ng Philippine National Police, one time lang po ang magpa-register ka. Ha? One time lang yung registration natin. Ibig sabihin, hindi ka na mag-renew. Okay? This is the difference between firearms and airsoft tsaka airguns. Kasi yung firearms, dapat nirenew yan. Ha? Nagre-renew ka. Pero sa airsoft at saka sa airgun, one-time registration lang po. Pag mag-transfer of ownership, yung qualified citizen, the same procedure po. Ah, the same procedure in the transfer of regular airgun shall apply. So, kailangan bang mag-register? The answer is yes. One time lang po. Pangalawa, transport. Kailanganin ba ng permit? pag mag-transport ka ng airsoft or airgun, the answer is yes. Kasi kailanganin po ang PTT or Permit to Transport. Permit to transport airsoft rifle pistol shall be required for the transport of all airsoft rifles pistols from the place of residence to any game or exhibition site. Klarong-klaro po yan, ha? Klarong-klaro po. So, this will serve as an additional knowledge to all of us po, di ba? Mga kadete, kailanganin pala. Pag may airsoft ka or may airgun ka or may air rifle ka or may air pistol ka, dapat may PTT pala or permit to transport. Ha? Pag nag-transport ka ng airsoft, dapat pala yung mga airgun natin, dapat registered yan. Dapat registered pala. Now, during gun ban, ganito po, di ba? We have Omnibus Code of Election. Di ba? We have the COMELEC. Ang COMELEC for the Commission on Election, usually they implement gun ban on the advent of campaign season or on the advent of election season. Now, marami po ang nangyayari in the society na yung tao nagdadala siya ng airsoft or airgun, the airsoft or airgun was confiscated and the person was detained. Question, legal po ba yan under gun ban? Ang sagot po, yes. Yes po yan. Because under Resolution 9561-8 in the Commission of Election, allow me to read po, yung firearm shall refer to the firearm as defined in the existing laws, rules, and regulation. Ibig sabihin, yung definition natin ng firearm sa 10591 is applied in this resolution. Pero may additional. Yung additional na inilagay sa resolution, naging kasali po ang air guns, airsoft guns, even replicas or imitation or firearms in whatever form. Kasi ang rason po nila, people might be panicked because they might believe that they are real. So ang tanong again, kung may airsoft ka, may pellet gun ka during election ban, tapos nag-checkpoint, tapos nakuha yun, ma-detain ka, legal ba? O legal yan kasi election ban. Yung definition of firearm natin sa Republic Act 10591, wherein it excludes airsoft tsaka air rifles, iba po ang definition sa COMELEC during gun ban. Kasi yung firearm natin, under this resolution, does not only include yung definition natin sa Republic Act 10591. Again, binigyan po ng additional na mga items. Yung additional na mga items na mga ito yung mga airsoft tsaka airgun. So, kasali po yan sa gun ban during election season. So, I hope klarong-klaro po, ha? I hope klarong-klaro yung explanation natin in as far as airsoft, airgun, and definition of firearms are concerned. Now, let's go to the general classes of firearms, cadets. Ito, there's a big possibility na lalabas po ito sa board examination. Marami po tayong classification or classes of firearms. This is according to a specific area po. Unahin po natin yung classification of firearms according to mechanical internal construction of gun barrel. Classification of firearms according to the gun barrel, ha? At ano ang gun barrel niya? Internal construction ng gun barrel. Dalawa lang po, rifled bore. Pangalawa, smooth bore. Ano bang pagkaiba sa dalawa? Rifled bore firearm, ibig sabihin may riflings yan. Ano ba yung riflings? Di ba sa episode 1, we talk about this. Yung riflings, yun po yung mga lands, tsaka yung grooves. Ano ba yung lands? Lands are those elevated portion of the riflings. Ano ba yung grooves? Grooves are the depressed or the canal-like portion of the riflings. Bakit importante ang riflings? Kasi it can provide what we call as gyroscopic stability during the flight of the bullet. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng gyroscopic stability under episode 1? Ibig sabihin, it will provide accuracy po sa target. Okay? So, ano bang classification yan? Rifled bore firearms. Pangalawa, yung firearms na walang riflings, for example, yung sa muskets, 'di ba? Yung sa muskets, all firearm po ito. Or shotguns. Muskets and shotguns, wala po yung riflings. So, sila, ang mga firearms na ito na wala mga riflings, ang classification nila is smoothbore firearms. Pangalawa, yung firearms naman can be classified according to the projectiles. Kanina, according to the internal gun barrel. Ito, according to projectiles. Now, dalawa lang po, artillery or small arms. Matawag siya na artillery if in case the projectile being propelled is more than 1 inch in diameter. More than 1 inch in diameter yung projectile na propel. Ibig sabihin, you have to measure it. Ha? You have to measure it. Pag yung diameter niya is more than 1 inch, at tawag niya is artillery na. Like for example, mortar, cannon, bazooka, M203, grenade launcher. So basically, these are artillery na. Pero yung small arms are those firearms that can propel projectile less than 1 inch in diameter. So pag less than 1 inch in diameter niya, yung projectile niya, for example, .45 caliber, yung .38 or yung sa revolver or yung sa rifle, maliliit lang po yung projectile, maliliit lang po yung bullet. So, maklasify po siya na small arms. Yan po ang pangalawang classification, cadets, ha. Yung pangatlong classification natin is according to mechanical construction na. Sa mechanical construction natin, may pito po tayo na klase ng mga firearms. Dapat intindihin po natin ito, ha, isa-isa. Una is single shot firearms. So pag single shot, paglalabas to sa board exam, easy lang po. Bakit single shot firearm? Kasi it is designed to fire only one shot for every loading. So every loading, one shot. One shot, one load. Pagkatapos ng one load, you pull the trigger, you fire to the target, tapos loading ka na naman. So, single shot firearm. Pangalawa, yung repeating firearms. Repeating firearms is opposite to single shot. Kasi yung repeating firearms po, is designed to fire several rounds for cartridges in one loading. For example, yung .45 caliber firearm natin, 'di ba? Marami 'yan, yung isang magazine, ang dami po na cartridges or ammunition na inilagay. So one loading lang, you can fire several shots, okay? One loading lang. Hindi tulad ng single shot, load ka ng isa, you shot, then load ka naman uli. Pero yung repeating firearm, one loading lang, isang magazine, ang dami ng ammunition. Number 3, yung automatic firearm. Sa automatic firearm, yung mechanism niya are so arranged that it will reload fresh cartridge and unload fire cartridge case after firing. Yung automatic firearms, pwede siyang full automatic, pwede ding semi-automatic. So automatically, pag nag-pull ka ng trigger, automatic it will load the cartridge. Ha? It will load the cartridge. It will feed the cartridge there para at least ready for the next firing naman. Ang ibig sabihin dyan, automatic firearm. Pang-apat na type of firearm according to mechanical construction, itong tinatawag na bolt action type. Okay, may picture po ako later na i-present para at least maintindihan po kung ano po ba yung picture o ano po ba yung sistema sa bolt action type. Yung bolt action type firearms that are provided with a box magazine under the bolt, but some of them have tabular magazine like a trombone action firearm. So pakita ko po later yung picture ng bolt action type. Yung automatic loading type, pareho lang po yan ng automatic firearm. Wala pong pinagkaiba, spelling lang po. Automatic loading type, ibig sabihin, when you fire the first shot, automatic may feeding or loading sa chamber. Para at least pag squeeze ka ng trigger, automatic you can perform the shot. Yung pang-anim natin is yung slide pump or action type. For example, yung sa shotgun natin. Slide palm action type po yan. This type of firearm can be opened by the grasping, the forearm, which is usually a wooden part of the gun, located under the barrel. This firearm is designed to slide back. Slide pump action type kasi nag-slide ka, slide back and forth para at least para sa feeding ng ammunition. Yung sa lever naman, the trigger guard of this type of firearm is hinged at the front end which is connected with a breech mechanism. So ipakita ko po later. After firing, the finger lever is moved downward so as to cause the trigger guard to pivot on its hinge and its forward extension is to move back para sa loading ng ammunition. Ito na po ang picture natin para mas maintindihan po ng mga kadete natin under forensic ballistics. O ganito ha, yung unang type, di ba may 5 types. Ito, hindi na mention to, yung brick action. Yung sa brick action, you somehow bend it and you put the ammunition or the cartridge. Tapos, bend uli, tapos you can do the firing. Yung lever action type po, ito po, makikita nyo yung arrow, yan po ang lever. Yan po ang lever. Now, we have to be pulled up or pulled down para at least the ammunition can be loaded. Yung sa bolt action type naman, yung sa mga movie natin na makikita, na inilagay yung ammunition at the top, tapos in-insert, ang tawag po dyan, bolt action type, yung ginagamit ng mga sniper sa mga old movies. Bolt action type po. Yung pump action type naman, tingnan nyo yung arrow, yung pump action type naman, nasabi ko kanina, ito po ang ginagamit sa shotgun. Pero sa shotgun, mayroon din po tayong brick action type, ha? Mayroon po tayong brick action type. Pero usually, makikita nyo, especially sa Dumaguete City, yung mga security guards natin, ang ginagamit nila is yung pump action type na shotgun. Okay? So, yan po ang mga classification of firearms according to mechanical construction. Now, baka lalabas po ito kasi 2011, board examination, lumabas ito. Yung pinakamaliit, o yung pinakamalaking firearm actually. In the history po, yung Germany ang gumawa ng pinakamalaking, the largest gun ever used in combat. Makikita nyo po yan sa picture, ang laki. Ha, diba? Malaki po ang firearm na yan. Ang tawag po dyan is German Gustav gun. Okay? German Gustav gun, huwag kalimutan, pinakamalaking firearm, pinakamalaking gun ever used in combat. Yung zip gun naman, ang zip gun na words can be applied to homemade. Sa Pilipinas po, tinatawag natin yung Paltic, di ba? Paltic guns, usually ginagawa yan sa Cebu, sa Danau noong araw, di ba? Paltic guns or homemade guns, sinatawag yung zip guns. This class of gun found to have a clever mechanism, most are effective weapons. So you can actually see in the picture, example po yan, ng tinatawag nating zip gun. Now, let's go to ammunition or cartridge. Pareho lang po ang term na yan, ha, cadets. Ang nakadiferensya lang po yan, spelling lang, ha. Spelling lang po. Pag ibig sabihin ng ammunition, cartridge. Pag cartridge, ammunition. Pareho lang po yan. So, ang ammunition or cartridge refers to the loaded shells for rifles, carbines, shotguns, revolvers, pistols from which a ball, bullet, shot, shell, or other missile may be fired by means of a gunpowder po. By means of a gunpowder. Ang ammunition or cartridge, tinatawag din yung complete unfired unit. Bakit? Bakit po complete unfired unit? Kasi makikita nyo sa picture, ammunition yan ng pistol. Yung isa, ammunition coming from a shotgun. Unfired, complete unit, ibig sabihin, andyan pa yung bullet. Andyan pa yung bullet. Or andyan pa yung projectile, andyan pa yung cartridge case, andyan pa yung gunpowder, andyan pa yung primer. So pag kompleto pa po yan, naka-attach pa po lahat ng components ng ammunition at cartridge, so ibig sabihin po, complete unfired unit po yan. So, ang complete unfired unit, tinatawag yung cartridge or ammunition. Sir, ano bang pinagkaiba ng cartridge at yung cartridge case? Of course, again, yung cartridge, yung complete unfired unit. Yung cartridge case po, ito po yung container. Container na nilagyan ng priming mixture tsaka yung gunpowder. Okay? So, yan po ang pinagkaiba. Take note po, cadets, na ang ammunition or cartridge, sa definition natin, kasali na po yan ha, ang ammunition or cartridge ng air rifle at tsaka yung sa airsoft or sa airgun. So, kasali na po yan sa definition ng ammunition or sa cartridge. Now, tingnan natin ng maigi kung ano yung parts ng cartridge or ammunition. Okay? Discuss natin na isa-isa para at least comprehensive yung discussion natin. I put pictures para at least mas lalong maintindihan, ha? Mas lalong maintindihan. Una po na part at the top, pinakauna na part ng ammunition, ang tinatawag nating bullet. Yung bullet is a projectile propelled through the barrel of a firearm by means of an expansive force of gases coming from a burning gunpowder. Now, later on po, I will show you a video on how the burning process of the gunpowder will take place. Okay, later ha, para at least maintindihan natin ng maigi. Ang bullet po, huwag kalimutan, tinatawag din itong ball or shot. Okay? Ball or shot. Ball or shot, ha? Yan po ang other terms ng bullet. Now, dalawa lang po ang general classification dyan. Yung lead bullets, tsaka yung jacketed. Pag purely lead po or alloy, ha? Alloy lang po siya or lead lang yung bullet niya, tawagin natin yung lead bullet. Pero pag ang lead, nilagyan ng coating, so makikita nyo sa picture, for example, may arrow dyan, lead core, tapos makikita nyo yung copper jacket, meaning there's a coating, copper po yung coating niya, ang tawag po dyan is jacketed bullets. Pero pag purely lead lang or purely alloy, ang tawag dyan is lead bullet. Pero pag may naka-coating po, jacketed bullet. So, yan po ang pinagkaiba ng lead at saka yung jacketed bullets. Now, sa board examination in the previous, lumabas po ito, principal types of bullet po. Isa or dalawa dyan ay lalabas. So, tingnan po natin yung principal types. Kanina yung general. Ito, principal types. Una, ball bullets. Makikita nyo sa picture ha, ang example ng ball bullets. Have a soft lead core inside the jacket and are used against person. This is the original terminology for bullet. O, diba kanina sabi ko, bullet, pwedeng tawagin shot, pwedeng tawagin na ball. So, basically, ang ball bullets, ito po ang klase ng bullet consisting ng lead core. Tapos, sa labas niya, may jacket po. Ha? May jacket. Okay? Coated with another form of metal. Ang tawag po niya is ball bullets. Pero if we compare, mas soft po yung ball bullets compared sa armor piercing bullet. Kasi sa armor piercing bullet po, sa loob niya, in its core, may pinakamatigas na steel. Ang purpose ng matigas na steel at its core, it's actually to pierce through armors, ha? Yung mga metals, it can pierce through, makapasok po siya kasi yung core niya is a hardened steel. So makikita niyo sa picture, 'di ba? Yung core niya may particular type of steel which is hardened, and once this will travel towards the target, once it penetrates, it can actually pierce through metals or armored vehicle. The core is of pointed bot-tailed shape and is made of hardened tungsten, chrome steel, and has a blackened tip. used to penetrate armored cars and vehicles. So yan po ang pwedeng gamitin natin. Pero yung ball bullets, soft lang, so pwede natin magagamit in killing, you know, in killing flesh or individuals, in shooting targets like humans, pwede siya. Pero sa armor piercing bullets, pwede din sa humans, pero it will, you know, it's more applicable to armored cars or yung mga vehicles na consist of metals. Now, ang pangatlong principal type of bullet, itong tinatawag na tracer bullets. Tinatawag po siyang tracer kasi you can actually trace the direction or the trajectory when the bullet is on its flight towards the target. You can actually see, during night time po kasi, you can actually pinpoint kung ano po ba ang direction ng bullet mo, kung saan tumama. Tawag po dyan, tracer bullets. Makikita nyo sa picture, cadets, yung tip niya, colored red yan. Ha, yung tip niya. Sa lower picture po, makikita nyo, pag it will travel from the muzzle of the firearm towards the target, during the flight po, it will emit a smoke or a light. So during night time, makikita mo actually kung ano yung direction ng bullet mo, kung saan tumama. Ha? Kung saan tumama. Ang tawag po dyan, tracer bullet. Yung incendiary bullet naman, yung pang-apat natin, ito po yung type of bullet, pag nakahit siya sa target, it will explode. Okay? It will explode. Contain a mixture such as phosphorus or other materials that can be set on fire by impact. These are used on targets that will readily burn such as aircraft and gasoline depot. So basically, ang incendiary bullet po, may mechanism po siya. So makikita nyo sa picture, may mechanism siya na sa loob dyan, ha, sa loob ng ng bullet, may combination of a mixture, for usually phosphorus and other materials that once it hit the target, it could create fire or an explosion. So pag na-hit yung aircraft or yung gasoline depot, nako, ang mangyayari po, it will explode, it will create fire. Yung panglima, itong explosive or fragmentary bullets. Andiyan po yung picture, at least klaro po. Contains a high charge of explosive. So ang explosive fragmentary bullets, once it hits the target, mas malaki po yung damage niya kasi it will create more damage in terms of the explosion. Yung incendiary could create fire, pero ito, it could create, you know, an explosion of a higher degree. So mas malaki po yung chance na malaki yung damage compared to the other bullets. Now, may marami pa po tayong types of bullets. Actually, napakarami kasi marami tayong firearm manufacturer po. Pero I will only highlight, cadet, sa yung pinaka-common. Common lang po kasi pag isa-isahin natin, napakarami, it will take us for eternity. So, I will only concentrate on other types which are very common. For example, itong dum-dum bullets. Bakit ito tinatawag na dum-dum? Kasi it was made in Dum-Dum, India. Okay? It was a type of bullet that were invented by British Ordnance Force Station at their arsenal at Dum-Dum, India. So this was during the war between British people and the Indians. Ang Dum-Dum bullet ngayon, ang bagong pangalan niya is hollow point bullet or soft point bullet. Andyan po yung example. Tinatawag siyang hollow point kasi sa gitna dyan, it's actually a hole. Hindi po yan solid. So once it hits the target, it will expand. So once it expands, what will happen is it will create more damage on the target. On the other hand, may tinatawag tayong gas check bullet. So gas check bullet po, huwag kalimutan, sa ilalim niya, yung base niya may copper caps. So pag may copper caps, huwag kalimutan, gas check bullet. To prevent the melting of the base, lead bullets intended to be fired at a higher velocity have their gases protected with a small copper caps. Kasi ang mangyari, kasi dyan, pag ang bullet, lead siya and it will travel from the ammunition, posible pong masusunog yung base niya because of the burning gas. So in order to avoid the melting of the base, nilagyan siya ng copper. Ang tawag po, gas check bullet. Mayroon din tayong tinatawag na wad cutter bullet. So wad cutter bullet is a cylindrical bullet designed having a sharp shouldered nose. Huwag kalimutan, sharp shouldered nose ang tawag po, wad cutter bullet. Okay, wad cutter bullet. Yung last, ito po ang tinatawag natin na wax bullet. Ginagamit lang po ito sa short range or indoor target shooting. Indoor lang po ha, yung indoor. For example, for fun or for practice, pwede ito, wax bullet. Kasi yung bullet niya consists of paraffin. Paraffin and other wax prepare. Wax lang po. Kaya tinatawag siyang wax bullet. Okay? So, yan po ang other types. Very common types of bullets. Now, note cadets, note po ang differences between shots, pellets, or slugs. Okay? Shots, pellets, slugs, or bullet. Usually, ang bullet po will include yung projectile coming from .45 caliber, yung sa mga revolver, yung sa rifle, bullet po. Pero ang sabi ko kanina, ang bullet will include shots. Pero specifically po, ang shots or pellets, pareho lang po yan. Shots or pellets, if these are the projectiles propelled by the ammunition coming from the shotgun. So makikita nyo ha, pag marami po, parang ano, para small balls, round po yan, shots ang tawag or pellets. Dalawa kasi ang klase ng ammunition ng shotgun. Pwede yung ammunition na may shots, pwede yung walang shots. Yung walang shots, yung single ammunition lang, ang tawag dyan is slug. Okay? Kuha nyo po ang difference. Shots, pag ano, magpag may round balls. Pero pag isa lang yung projectile na lumabas from the shotgun, ang tawag po dyan is slug. So makikita nyo, shot on the other one, tapos slug on the other side, pareho sila ng cartridge case, may wad with shot cap on the other picture, may wad naman on the other one, we also have gunpowder, and of course, you can see the primer. Yun po ang differences between shots or pellets. Again, shots or pellets are those kind of round balls that are projected from the shotgun. Yung slug naman, isa lang na projectile propelled by the shotgun. Both of the two are propelled by the same, by the shotgun. Okay, shotgun po ang ginagamit. Okay, now, punta naman tayo sa number 2. Kanina, ang discussion natin was about the first part ng ammunition, yung bullet. Ito, pangalawa ha. Pangalawang part ng bullet, ang cartridge case. Ang sabi ko kanina, ang cartridge case is just a container. Iba po yung cartridge, iba din po yung cartridge case. Yung cartridge is the complete unfired unit. Tinatawag din siyang ammunition. Pero yung cartridge case, isa lang po yung container. Part po yan ng cartridge or part po yan ng ammunition. Ano po ba ang purpose nito is container ng gunpowder. At the same time, ang cartridge case, tinatawag din yung casing or shell. Huwag kalimutan ha, casing or shell. Isa lang po ang ibig sabihin dyan, cartridge case. Shell or casing, cartridge case pa din yan. Anong purpose ng cartridge case? Container siya ng gunpowder, ng primer, tsaka yung bullet. Ano ang other terms? Shell and casing. So I hope ha, huwag kalimutan ang other significant terms. Now, another part of the ammunition or cartridge case, itong gunpowder. Okay? Ang gunpowder, tinatawag yang propellant. So huwag kalimutan ha, propellant or powder charge. Ang gunpowder was actually first invented by Roger Bacon. Sino po ba ang nag-invento? Si Roger Bacon. Pero nung araw, ang naimbento niya ay yung tinatawag na black powder. Kaya when the gunpowder is ignited, it will create a lot of black smoke. Tinatawag siyang black powder. Pero when after the invention of Roger Bacon, dumating si Paul Viel. Si Paul Viel ang nag-invento ng tinatawag nating smokeless gunpowder. Although there is a smoke, but the smoke is much lesser in amount compared to black powder. So black powder, Roger Bacon. Smokeless gunpowder, Paul Viel. Okay? So I hope naintindihan ha. I hope naintindihan ka. I hope I give justice as far as a comprehensive discussion is concerned. Note, huwag kalimutan, the weight of the gunpowder in a cartridge is expressed in grains, kung ano kadami yung grains, in English-speaking countries. Pero, but in countries which use the metric system, the weight is expressed in terms of grams, yung weight. Okay? This talks about the weight. In English countries, English-speaking countries, by grains po siya, kung ano ang dami ng grains. Yun po ang basehanan ng weight. Pero sa metric system countries na gumagamit ng, you know, metric system, yung weight po is expressed in terms of grams. Whether it is 5 grams, 10 grams, 100 grams, 200 grams, whatever. Next, ang standard ingredients of black powder, lumabas po ito sa previous board examination. Ha, familiarize na lang po, kadete ha. Familiarize na lang, or if possible, memorize nyo na lang po to. Kasi may percentages eh. So you can see, potassium nitrate 75%, sulfur 10%, charcoal 15%. So you just memorize it this way. Potassium nitrate 75, sulfur 10, charcoal 15. Or from bigger to lower, like say potassium nitrate 75, charcoal 15%, sulfur 10%. So yan po ang combination ng black powder or black gunpowder. Now, the other parts of ammunition, tapos na po tayo sa bullet, cartridge case, tsaka gunpowder. Punta naman tayo sa primer. So ano ba ang primer? Ang primer contains what we call as a priming mixture. Remember, between the gunpowder and the priming mixture, ang priming mixture po is tinatawag yan the most sensitive mixture. The most sensitive mixture for combustion. Ang priming mixture. Saan po makikita ang priming mixture? Makikita po ang priming mixture sa primer. Okay? So, pag ang priming mixture, ang primer, ma-hit by impact, by the firing pin, the priming mixture inside will ignite. After it will ignite, the ignition will travel or will conflagrate to the gunpowder, di ba? Under episode 1, once the fire will conflagrate to the gunpowder, pressure will be created. Tapos yung pinaka-soft part niya is yung sa bullet side, kaya it will propel the bullet forward. It will propel the bullet forward. So ano po ba yung pinaka-sensitive dyan? Ito po yung priming mixture na makikita sa primer. Ang primer po is a complete assembly of the priming mixture, the paper disc, the anvil, and the vent. Okay, yan po ang parts ng primer. Saan makikita ang primer? O makikita nyo sa ano? Sa picture, nasa ilalim po yan ha. Yung ammunition coming from the rifle o ammunition coming from the shotgun, makikita nyo yung primer. Okay, nandyan po makikita ang priming mixture. Ang composition ng priming mixture ganito po. Potassium chloride 45%, antimony sulfide 23%, fulminate of mercury 32%. In kaso lang po, paglalabas ito sa board examination, at least familiar na po kayo. Now, para maintindihan cadets, kung ano talaga ang mangyayari during the impact, kasi ang target ko in this discussion is at least man lang, I can comprehensively discuss to you and you will understand on the topics I discussed. Kaya, I will play a video, an animated video coming from YouTube, an animated video on what will happen during the time when the trigger is pulled up to the point that the bullet will go out or is discharged coming from the muzzle of the firearm. So tingnan po natin and familiarize yung mga actions na mangyayari inside the firearm. Now, I hope klaro na po ha. I hope everything is clear na po. At least kung ano ang mangyayari inside the firearm. Again, sa episode 1, we talk about interior, exterior, terminal, tsaka yung forensic ballistics. Kindly visit episode 1 po para at least maklarify natin lahat ha. Maklarify natin lahat yung nangyayari inside the firearm. To the point that the bullet will leave from the muzzle. Okay, so by that video po, I hope I was able to shed light sa lahat ng confusions natin about what will happen inside the firearm. Now, punta na tayo sa classification of cartridge, okay? Classification of cartridge na po tayo. I think this is now the second to the last. Classification of cartridge according to the RIM muna tayo. Nilagyan ko po yan ng picture para at least makikita nyo ha. Makikita nyo ang differences. Unahin natin lima yan. Unahin natin ang RIM. Ang RIM is a type of a cartridge wherein the diameter of the RIM is greater than the diameter of the body of the cartridge case. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng RIM? Ha? Ibig sabihin ng RIM yung sa base part niya. So makikita nyo sa RIM type, yung pinakauna dito, ha, may nakapangalan dyang RIM, makikita nyo na yung diameter ng RIM is mas malaki compared to the body. Mas malaki compared to the body. Okay, tingnan nyo yung base. Mas malaki yung base niya compared to the body. Tawag niya RIM type. Semi-RIM type, pag ang diameter of the rim is slightly greater than the diameter of the body of the cartridge case. Makikita nyo yan ha, slightly greater lang yung rim niya ha? Compared to the cartridge case. Yung rimless naman, yung rim niya tsaka yung body, makikita nyo equal po yung diameter. Mas pareho lang po yung yung diameter nila, nilang dalawa, yung cartridge case, tsaka yung rim. Yung riveted type naman, yung diameter ng rim niya, mas maliit, makikita nyo? Mas maliit, di ba? Yung base niya, mas maliit, compared sa body. Compared sa cartridge case niya. So, ang tawag niya, riveted. Riveted ang tawag. Belted type naman, there is a protruding metal around the body of the cartridge case near the rim. So, makikita nyo po yung example. So, may protruding metal po siya. Usually, ginagamit ito ng magnum type of firearm. So, ito po ang mga classification of cartridges according to the rim. Now, punta naman tayo sa types of cartridge cases according to the location of the primer. Kung saan makikita yung primer. Sabi ko kanina, ang primer consists of a priming mixture na highly sensitive that once hits by the firing pin, ang mangyari, it will ignite. Okay? So, saan po ba makikita yung primer? Una, may examples dito ha. Pinfire. Sa pinfire cartridge, makikita nyo yan. The pin extend radially through the bead of the cartridge case into the primer. Ito ha, makikita nyo, there's a protruding metal, yung maliit. Yan po ang i-hit, ito. Yan po ang i-hit by the firing pin. Pag na-hit po yan, it will ignite. Pero, huwag kalimutan, wala na po tayo ngayon sa old times na gumamit pa tayo ng pin fire. Wala na pong pin fire, obsolete na po yan. Ang ginagamit po itong rim fire or itong center fire. Ano po ba ang pinagkaiba? Yung rim fire, nilagay yung priming mixture in the cavity formed in the rim of the head of the cartridge case. So makikita mo sa rim fire, nasaan ba yung primer niya? Nasa side. Nasa rim mismo. Nasa rim mismo, kaya tinatawag yung rim fire. Pero yung center fire, yung priming mixture niya nakalagay sa gitna, sa center. Yung rim nakalagay sa rim, yung priming mixture. Pero sa center fire, nakalagay yung priming mixture niya sa center or sa gitna. Yung percussion naman, yung percussion which is obsolete also, a means of ignition of propellant changed by a mechanical blow against the primer or percussion cap. So, dito sa picture, makikita nyo yung cap, yung plug, yung hammer. So, yung hammer will hit the cap. Pag na-hit yan ng cap, automatic the priming mixture will ignite. Yung ignition niya will travel to the gunpowder and the gunpowder will burn and it will create pressure. So ito po ha, huwag niyo po itong kalimutan. Types of cartridge cases according to the primer tsaka yung classification of cartridge cases or cartridge according to the rim. Note, I put an additional note. Low power. A cartridge giving a muzzle velocity less than 1,850 feet per second. High power cartridge. A cartridge giving a muzzle velocity between 1925 and 2,500 feet per second. High intensity. A cartridge giving a muzzle velocity over 2,500 feet per second. Yan po, familiarize na lang po yan. I add it para at least mas comprehensive para paglalabas. I do not fail to mention it in the review. Now, lastly po, we will be talking about the functions of the cartridge case. Okay? So, repeat lang po natin and specify natin kung ano ba talaga yung functions ng cartridge cases. Again, number one, it holds the bullet, gunpowder, and primer. Container po siya. At the same time, a waterproof container for the gunpowder and it prevents the escape of gases to the rear. So, ito po ang function ng cartridge case. So again, ang cartridge case po, container po siya for the gunpowder and the primer. At the same time, waterproof container din po for the gunpowder. At the same time, disallow or prevent the escape of gases at the lower portion. So ito po ang mga purposes ng cartridge cases. Cadets, I would like to stop in this topic mo now. Let's relax for a while kasi too much of something is bad. Again, I'll be putting this in 4 episodes. The reason again why I put this or break this into 4 episodes.